The GigaDrive is apparently the world's fastest external SSD, or at least that's what it says on its Indiegogo page, which, by the way, has exceeded its funding by almost 5,000%, so it seems people are buying into the hype. Now, I love making videos on external storage solutions, and obviously the team behind GigaDrive watches my videos because they reached out to me to review this product. Quick disclaimer, I was sent this product for free, but this video is entirely my own opinion and has not been influenced or sponsored by GigaDrive at all. They didn't even watch the video before I published it. The big selling points of the GigaDrive is that it claims speeds of up to 2800 megabits per second, and that it's water, dust, and shock resistant, and don't you worry, we'll be putting it to the test in this video to make sure those claims are valid. A quick thanks to Wondershare's Vidair for sponsoring this video. Vidair is a creative online video maker designed to make video marketing easier on small businesses. They help users create marketing videos to effectively promote anything in just minutes. You get creative templates for every business, attractive text effects and stickers to make your videos stand out, and 10,000 plus free video, photo and music resources. Try it for free on your Windows or Mac device by clicking the link in the description down below. Let's start with the build quality. Honestly, I'm impressed. There are rubber pads on the bottom so it doesn't slide around too much. The case is aluminum alloy and feels very sturdy and rugged to the touch. It has some weight to it, although it doesn't feel quite as chunky and heavy as the Sabrent Thunderbolt 3 SSD enclosure I've featured previously on this channel. The reason having a thick enclosure is important is to dissipate heat, because NVMe SSD drives can get very hot. More on this later. In terms of speed, it certainly is quite fast. I tested it against several other popular external drives on the market, including my very own custom 2TB NVMe SSD drive that I put together for only around $230. Starting on an Intel Mac, I was able to get some pretty respectable speeds of around 2400 megabits per second read and 2300 megabits per second write, absolutely destroying the Samsung T5 and T7, and even the Sabrent Thunderbolt 3 enclosure with the Rocket NVMe SSD. Some of you may already know that the USB-C ports on M1 Macs have performance issues when using external drives. As a result, the speeds are a bit wacky, as you can see with the increased read speed but much lower write speed on the GigaDrive. Although this is no fault of the GigaDrive, as it happens with pretty much every other SSD drive. Transferring files is an absolute breeze, although I doubt you'll be transferring more than about 100 to 200 gigabytes of files at a time, as most Mac owners only have between 256 gigabytes to 512 gigabytes of storage on their internal drive. Thermal throttling caused by transferring huge amounts of files seems to be minimal, and this is where the solid metal chassis comes in advantageous. It simply takes longer to heat up to the point that transfer speeds slow. I don't think you'll have issues unless you're transferring over 500 gigabytes in a single go, and even then the speeds will only slow marginally. Now let's examine the boldest claim that GigaDrive makes, its ability to withstand dust, dirt, and water. Its IP67 rating is the same as many popular smartphones currently on the market. What does IP67 even mean? Well, the 6 indicates the internal components are completely protected against solid objects from entering, including dust, while the 7 indicates it can be completely submerged in 1 meter of water for up to 30 minutes before moisture penetrates the housing. So I went out and buried my GigaDrive in the backyard, dug it up again, and then washed it off with a gentle stream from the hose. I didn't use a more powerful jet option on purpose because IP67 doesn't protect against that type of pressure. I pretty much used the same amount of pressure that's shown on the actual GigaDrive product page. Then I dunked it in a glass of water for about 10 seconds. After thoroughly drying it with a towel, blowing and cleaning out the USB-C port, and allowing it to dry for a few hours, it was dead. So I decided to open it up and immediately saw moisture had entered the enclosure. I also saw that there were no seals around the edges of the two pieces and also where the enclosure surrounds the USB-C port. This is pretty standard in my opinion to have on IP67 rated devices such as iPhones, as you can see in this image. The GigaDrive is relying on nothing more than the two edges of the enclosure being a perfect seal, which is almost impossible without a gasket or seal of some type. For example, rubber or glue. There was also no protection around the screw holes apart from the rubber feet, so that's another possible entry point for water and moisture. Strangely enough, it started working about 10 minutes later, but I don't feel comfortable in agreeing with the IP67 rating as stated on the website. I believe it is water resistant at best, which means it should not be submerged or exposed to any amount of water larger than light rain for a few seconds, for example. Moving on to drop and shock resistance, this is something I can agree with. It's a very solid design and will likely be fine if you drop it. I didn't have any issues with some moderate height drops I tested. That being said, if you drop it and the impact creates a tiny gap between the two parts of the enclosure, it will make it even less water resistant. At the moment, the GigaDrive is priced insanely low for what you get, almost 50% off the RRP. This can be explained by it still being in the funding period on Indiegogo. It isn't actually available for purchase yet, hence they are keeping the price artificially low to create a buzz and market for the product. This is pretty typical of Kickstarter and Indiegogo campaigns. Personally, I think it's a great price if you can get it at a discount, and even the full RRP is relatively typical for a drive of this particular capacity and speed. Even if you were to build your own Thunderbolt drive, the price would come out very similar. In conclusion, I think the GigaDrive is actually a fairly solid external drive. The speeds are fast, it is quite rugged, and the price is on par with the competition. However, I do not agree with its IP67 classification and advise you to keep it away from water should you buy one. Unless, of course, somehow GigaDrive adds some kind of seal around the edges of the enclosure, like I mentioned previously. Anyway, thanks for watching this video. Let me know in the comment section if you have any questions, but apart from that, I'll see you in the next one.